Hello guys, in this video we will see the composition of two linear transformation. So for function, if f is a function, it maps x to y, and g is another function which maps y to z, then the composition of f of g is equals to f of g of x. Same thing happens in the case of linear transformation. So theorem, we are stating a theorem. Let L and T are two linear maps which are defined appropriately. So that the composition L of T is meaningful then the composition of the two linear transformation L of T will be linear map will be linear transformation So it means if L is a transformation which maps x to y and there exist a matrix A is the matrix if there exist a matrix so A is the matrix corresponding to this transformation such that L of some vector from x this will be A into x vector and this belongs to y the vector space y and the another transformation t is defined from y to z and there exist b b is the matrix there exist a matrix b such that t of y vector is equals to b into y vector this belongs to vector space z so now the composition of these two linear transformation says that L of T which is equals to L of T so if I give x as input it will become L of T of x So first this parenthesis will be solved so t of x will be bx matrix b into x vector now this whole thing will be evaluated so it will be a into this vector t of x is b into x so this whole will be ab x vector a is the matrix corresponding to the transformation l B is the matrix corresponding to the transformation T and X is the vector which we are giving as input to this composition of these two linear transformation. So this transformation is linear. It means it will follow, it will satisfy this condition L of T alpha X vector X1 vector you take and beta X2 vector then it will be equals to alpha into L of T x1 vector plus beta into L of T x2 vector we are not going to prove here anything it is straightforward so the theorem states that let L and T are two linear maps defined in such a way that their composition L of T is meaningful means it exists then the composition of these two linear maps will again a linear transformation I hope you understand thank you